24 losses, a boxer who made his debut on October 2017. Help me introduce Francis Ayi. And his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, he will be 141 pounds, fighting out of the Accra boxing club, the boxer known as Junior Wonder, with a fighting record. Right.
Thank you.
Yeah. the group boxing gym and fighting out of a red corner with a fighting record of 6 fights, 5 wins, 5 draws, 1 draw, and 5 of his wins came by way of KO. A boxer known as Mayweather. Help me introduce Michael Ikane.
Zico. bantam. Enye bantam we. Enye ba ma shile. Boss. Enye. Thank you.
fighters with one fight losing you. Now, now we need to done it. Two wins, one draw, two of the wins coming by way of KO.
Caleb, there's Caleb water there. I thought you called me, there's Caleb water there. From out there.
Alaji.
Thank you.
In all white apparel, with a fighting record of 2 fights
Thank you. Thank you. So the end of man went down twice and bumps back here in style.
Of Ghana against the Boro of Benin.
Yeah.
need. He has to take on the green right in front of his own people. You can see Coach Swiss. Coach Swiss of the Sonia Gym with Izekiana. Izekiana and the excavator versus Imoro of Benin. Super featherweight contest scheduled for 8. It's an international, you know, contest between boxers from two different countries, two West African countries, Ghana and Benin. So the stage has been set, and after this fight, we have the main event. Samuel Takyi, the man, they call him Ring Warrior. You know him, everybody knows him. He's a man who won Ghana's only medal at last year's Olympic Games. Africa's only boxing medal. And now he goes pro tonight. But before then, we'll see this fight. Izekiana in the yellow trunks against the guy in the red from Benin. Imoro, they call him. Imoro. And it appears both boxers are, you know, primed up for this occasion. They putting up a show right from the very beginning. Imoro with the left jab. He tries a combination there by Anan. Goes down to business. Anan, a very experienced campaigner, has been around for a number of years. Imoro with the double combination by his right back by Anan. Izeke Anan, the man in the yellow. The Ghanaian against the man from Benin, Imoro. Here at the Bukom Boxing Arena, the Gamashi Hall. The organizers. The organizers of this show
Ça va comme ça, c'est bon. Attention avec God. Dans la vente. Voilà. C'est bon. C'est bon. C'est bon. C'est bon comme ça. C'est bon. Faut prendre garde. Prends garde. Ah. Prends garde. Prends garde.
Prends garde. For God, mon nom.
Opening down la van.
Jab, jab, jab.
Van, ce n'est pas la van.
referee, one of the new, you know, officials on the block. He strikes the two boxers to begin the second round, which is underway here at the Kamasi Hall of the Bukom Boxing Arena. Accra, Ghana. Good Friday night, 2022. Oh, it's another local combination there from Imoro. Imoro is here on a mission. And Anna, you have to. And in, Imoro. Imoro at work. And Beninoa, really, is punishing the Ghanaian. Anna tries to also take the fight to the opponent. Oh, Anan is not a man who will go down easily, but whenever he tries to go, your man from Benin Imoro has a punch waiting. It's round two here, and so far, Imoro from Benin seems to be in control. He knows when to land his punches, and they are on point. Another double combination there to the body of Anna, who tries to hammer a punch there but wouldn't land against the fast Beninoa. And Anna, oh, these two bosses are primed for this tonight. They are ready. They are giving their all. Both boxers. Both men. It's a give and take affair here in round two. Anna. In yellow. In the gold. Ghana's gold, Kale. Oh, another powerful rider there from Anan. By a good job there from Imoro. Final 10 seconds. So it's still a very tight affair here as we enter round three. This international super featherweight contest built for 8 rounds between the man from Ghana, Izetiana in the yellow, and Imoro, who has come all the way from Benin here in West Africa, two countries away from Ghana. Round three. Bazooka Promotions. You know, when you hear Bazooka, there's one name that comes into your mind. Ike Bazooka Porte. He is the man behind this promotion syndicate. And Anand tries to attack the opponent, but But Imoro is not a man who is going to go back. He tries another punch. Oh, he lands a very nice left jab there to the face. Anna goes to the body. But Imoro is always ready to counter. Oh, good right there from Imoro. Tries another one, but Anna fights. Anna on the attack. Full swing attack there from Anna. Oh, oh, Imoro. It's a good fight here. Both boxers, I can tell you, I told you right from the very beginning, you could see from the very opening seconds of this fight that both were ready to give it their all, and that's what we are witnessing here. In round three here in this fight. There's the Gamashi Hall of the Bukom Boxing Arena, Accra, Ghana. Friday night is Good Friday, the Easter Friday of 2022, 15th April. Good one there from Anna. And Anna is taking a bit of punishment again here in round three. He misses with a left uppercut. Oh, Anna goes to work, but he's up against a very tough customer in Imoro from Benin. Oh, that's a good one there from Anna to the body of Imoro. Anna goes to work again as we count down the end to the end of this round. Oh. And that's the end of round three here. Issues and instruction for them to begin round four. Oh, and now with the left. Anna will not stop chasing. Ezekiel Anna. Oh, he goes to the body of Imoro. Anna trying his best to bounce back here in this fight. As Imoro goes to work again. It's a tricky fight here, very, very tricky for both boxers. And Imoro is a very, very smart man. As Anna tries to attack, he makes sure he hits him first before the Ghanaian can, you know, get his punch landing. And another left there, Anna will chase him down. Anna knows he's in a tough battle, but he is not a man. He's very determined to also do something here. He's not backing down, Ezekiana. He keeps chasing Imoro, who seems to be, you know, having the effects of the pressure from Anand. Another powerful left right there from Anand, but Imoro quickly counters with the left. And now tries to punch again. It's a really nice fight here. Both boxers showing that they really came up here tonight to fight and go home with victory. Clear that whoever wins tonight will be a man who really deserves his victory. No one having it easy at all. And that's again another countdown to the end of this fourth round. And now tries to finish hard. And that's it. Round four is over. Verdict has been delivered. Anand, Team Anand, corner of Anand. Are you listening? Are you hearing? As we begin round five. Round 5, Ezekiel Anna versus Imoro of Benin. Ezekiel Nana of Ghana, of course. Anand, once again the aggressor here. And Anand goes on the attack. Oh, another powerful left there from Anand. And the champ, you should be out here at ringside watching. Musa Lawson telling us our camera position is not good at this time compared to the beginning of the round. We do our best for you, champ, but we thought as champ, you should have been here at ringside. Musa Lawson, the Ghana super welterweight champion, I think. Agbo Dade. And we continue here in round 5, Ezekiel Anand versus Imoro of Benin. Super featherweight contest scheduled for 8. Anand now appears to be getting the measure of Imoro. Imoro has hardly done anything in this round so far. The Ghanaian. The and Anand sleeps there. No problem, champ. There's a reason why you couldn't be here. Thank God you are able to watch it through Donald's corner. Ezekiel Anand, and that's the end of round five once again. It's a round which I think you know, taking control of this fight as we enter round six of eight. So it's only one more fight left here, the main event. The man, Samuel Takyi, making his professional bow. But until then, we'll have to be down with this business here between Ezekiel Anand and Imuro of Benin. Ebenezer Ajay, Coach Killer. Thank you very much. We'll do our best for you. Anand versus Imuro. International Super Featherweight contest. Eight rounds is going. And we are in the sixth stanza. Thank you very much, champ, Musa Lawson. Anand with a good one there to the head of Imuro. Anand. It's round six. Anand goes on the offensive once again. Oh, but Imuro, you know, tries to remember what he was doing previously in the beginning, at the beginning of this fight. Attacking at this point in time, round six. Anand goes by. It's Imuro who lands once again. Anand with a powerful right there. Imuro counters. It's a good fight here in round six. Super featherweight contest. Bazooka Promotions. Warriors win. Bazooka Fight Night. Oh! Another powerful left there.
fight.
So, the Ghanaian in cruise control. By our ringside observation. This is round 7. This is round 7. It's the Kiana of Ghana versus Imoro of Benin. Super featherweight 8 rounder. Left jab, not so powerful from Imoro. Imoro on the offensive, and now back pedals. And now goes, but it's hit with another thunderbolt from Imoro. Background issuing instructions in French. We certainly, not many of us can understand that here in Accra, Ghana, but his bossa is well understanding him very well, and that's what matters to them. Left jab there from Anan, who is in a comfortable lead here. Powerful one there from Anamba. Imoro counters. No boxers still up here. It could still go either way. Nobody appears weary, tired. No. They are just both sizing up each other. Anand lands one there. Another one from Anand. Oh. And it's Anand. So there you go, the final round here, round 8, international super featherweight contest between Ezekiel Anna of Ghana and Benin's Imoro, who is in the red, the Ghanaian is in the all yellow. It's Bazooka Promotions. Here at the Gamashi Hall of the Bukom Boxing Arena. Remember tomorrow, the Dilazi Professional Boxing League returns to this same Bukom Boxing Arena. Referee has an issue with Imoro and gives him a slight warning. Anna with the left jab. Anna on the offensive. And Imoro. Kiana not attacking here in the final round. He tries to do it now. and a very experienced coach. Killer plays the other one by 2-1. That should be a split point decision. Ghana is the winner by unanimous point decision. So now, it's like the only fight we came here for. Samuel Takyi, the man who won Ghana's only bronze medal at last year's Olympic Games, the man who won Africa's only boxing medal at the same games, the Swag Sports Personality of the Year. He's done it all. Now he's moving from amateur rounds into the professional realm. And tonight, right here, in some few minutes, we'll see him in the ring for the first time as a professional boxer. He takes on Kamarudeen Boyefio, who are here yesterday for the win. And now we are getting ready for the main fight. Samuel Takyi. You can see him here.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
said some water. Like he did, they say the age to be one for the major communication.
Bazooka Boxing Promotions. The other president, I, Bazooka Boxing, former of UBA, World Heavyweight Champion of the World, the manager, Clement Boxing, Patrick Junior and Boxing, and we have a lawyer, Nate Akama, who is the legal advisor of the company.
Gentlemen, it is no more longer lightweight, but rather cutweight fight between the two. Kamarudeen weighed 125.33, and Samuel Takyi also weighed in on the scale at 133.7. So it's a catch weight and not a lightweight contest between the two. So in your shot right now, with the golden hair and then the Ghana colors trunk, it's Samuel Takyi. And then the chap wearing blue and red trunks is Kamarudeen Boyefio. Very experienced boxer. Samuel Takyi in your shop right now. Samuel Takyi is the chap wearing the red, yellow, and green trunks. And then Kamarudeen Boyefio is in the blue and red trunks. So this is the debut fight of the young boxer. And a left jab to the chin of Kamarudeen Boyefio, and he visits the canvas in only round one, and this is really, really serious fight. A good combination of punches from Samuel Takyi, and it is superb exchange over here. Samuel Takyi really exhibiting very, very sweet artistry of boxing. Combination of punches from Samuel Takyi, and Kamarudeen Boyefio would always bend down to the trunks area of Samuel Takyi. A jab, flurry of punches to the head and face of Kamarudeen Boyefio. Another right hand to the body of Kamarudeen Boyefio. A left hook from Kamarudeen Boyefio, but another punch to him, and he goes. Kamarudeen taking too many punches from Samuel Takyi, and he visits the canvas once more. Kamarudeen Boyefio visits the canvas once more. Jab again to the body of Kamarudeen, and he goes again to the canvas. This is the third time he's going to the canvas. Referee Erasmus O counts Kamarudeen Boyefio, and it looks like we will end this fight in the early round. Bell saves Kamarudeen Boyefio, and the fans go ahead. And here we go again, a jab goes to the face of a left hook to the body of Kamarudeen. And I don't know why Kamarudeen Boyefio is not dishing out punches, I just don't know. A right upper hook,
uppercut to the face of Kamarudeen Boyefio, and he keeps running. I don't know why he keeps. Kamarudeen taking too many punches, and this is the second time he's going down in the second round again, and this is really serious. I don't know why he's gone down three times in the first round, twice in the second round. I don't know why he's continuing this fight, ladies and gentlemen. I just don't know why. A jab again to his face, and he keeps buying down again. I don't know why he's not dishing out any punch. He's taking too much punishment. And I think that the referee should stop this fight, because Kamarudeen is not throwing punch. Kamarudeen is just not throwing any punch, holding his hand. Referee Erasmus O should stop the fight. He's taking too much punishment from the Olympic medalist, Samuel Takyi. Thank you.
Yo, if it is this one, if it is this one. Come on. You take the mic. He not being here does not make the result invalid. Merci.
right. That was a terrific display. You were coming with two twisted attacks. Was it an easy victory or did you have some problems coming in there?
Yeah, you know, I did not have any problem. At the way, Kamarudeen coach said, Kamarudeen's experience was that. And I tell my fans know me as an amateur boxer, but I explained to them that I fought professional boxers at Olympics. So I'm an amateur boxer and also a professional boxer. And I tell Kamarudeen coach that I'll show him here. So I show him.
I keep hearing this phrase among the people. Show them. I don't know. In the amateur rounds, you put a light of the Reagan. In your rounds, you are now campaigning at lightweight. You are the likes of Ryan Garcia, Sofimo Lopez and Co. And you intimated during the conference that you have no seniors at the pro level. Do you still stand by that? And how do you see your future?
Yeah, I still stand by that because I'm an Olympian bronze medalist. And as you are talking, you called Ryan Garcia. And you know, his coach and his trainer has already defeated my trainer. So if I'm in Ryan Garcia's level, I'm ready for him. And I'm ready for everyone in life. Yeah.
That is our golden boy right here, the ring warrior. And he is saying that he's ready for any boxer and lightweight at the world level. So what are the future hold for you?
As I started my professional, I'll be going back and sit with my team, my coaches, and you know, and champ, him is a world champion, so he knows the road. He can lead us. So I'll also give chance to Bazooka Promotions. Thank you very much, and thank all of you, my team. God bless all of you. God bless all of you. God bless all of you. Those who pray for me. And also, once again, I'm not forgetting all of you in Ghana. Thank you for supporting me in the amateur level when I'm coming from Tokyo at the airport. The way you praise me at the airport. Thank you, all of you. God bless you.
Show them.
All right, Samuel Takyi, you are an epitome, a paragon of hope for Ghana boxing. Wish you all the best. You know that you climb to higher levels.
And last word, I want to tell Ghanaians, I'm making Ghana proud forever and to the world. I've made it in the amateur level. I'm making it to the professional level. So Ghanaians, let's go, we go. Are you ready?
We also have the son of Ike Forte. He's the president of Clement Forte. He's the manager of Samuel Takyi. One of the world with him. So your fighter has won his first, his pro debut. What are the plans in store for him?
We have to come back to the drawing board. We'll sit down and plan properly. Maybe get a couple of opponents for our boxers. So we'll show you guys that we're ready for everybody.
Was Kamarudeen a formidable opponent? And were you impressed by his output tonight? God bless. See ya. So I'm coming and I go to the rap.